time now for the PHL News Report on this Tuesday afternoon, December 15th, 2015. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Gino Wiggins. I get 12 noon news that I'm on this Tuesday afternoon here. Our top story at 12 noon here is officials close all Los Angeles Unified School District campuses on Tuesday morning after receiving a credible threat of violence involving backpacks and packages left at campuses. United Nations, the medium range email rocket that Iran tested on an October 10th was a ballistic missile capable of delivering a nuclear warhead, which will make a violation of the UN. Last night was at the world premiere for Star Wars The Force Awakens at the Dolby El Capitan and TCL Theaters Hollywood. Brussels, European Union authorities on Tuesday proposed taking control of border and coastal security at popular entry points for migrants to countries like Greece and Italy to get a grip on a crisis that has divided the Balkan and fed the rise. Calling the Islamic extremism a disease, as Saudi Arabia has announced the formation of a coalition of 34 predominantly Muslim nations to fight terrorism. Paris, French police arrested two men and a woman on Tuesday in connection with a deadly Islamic militant attack in Paris last month, and then January judiciary official said. Bakunin, Kazakhstan, a Soyuz rocket carrier and a Russian American in Britain blasted off on Tuesday from the Bakunin Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan in a smooth launch en route to the International Space Station. After claims that a Nazi train filled with gems and gold was buried in a tunnel in Poland, scientists say there is no evidence such a train actually exists. A global freedom of press advocacy group says that China and Egypt that led the world in a jailing journal says Beijing and Cairo attempt to silence dissent and eliminate stories that they viewed as anti-government. In Baltimore, Freddie Gray jury hard at work asking about Adams. Congress has deemed the EPA's efforts to promote public awareness of controversial water ruling to be legal activist propaganda as the nuance of social media can blur the lines along and around the traditional government communication. Former John Jay High School assistant football coach Mac Reed in Texas has been sentenced to probation and community service due to role in a referee assault case in September. Police say a Texas man in New Jersey rammed his pickup truck in the lobby of a hotel in Alva, Oklahoma, and Mary Milston, two terrified employees working the front desk. The ruble strengthened for the first time in 3 days, and Russian bonds rose with stocks as a sell-off crude abated as the currency gained 0.8% to advance it to 70.043 as of 6:43 p.m. Washington, the underlying U.S. inflation pressures rose in November, which could give the Federal Reserve more confidence to raise interest rates on Wednesday, even as renewed weaknesses in gasoline prices kept overall consumer prices in check. Wall Street was on track for the second day of gains on Tuesday as energy stocks rose in tandem with a recovery in oil prices and a day before a widely expected interest rate hike by the Federal Reserve in nearly a decade. Business conditions in the state of New York remain weak in December and extended a 5-month streak of deterioration, according to a Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Scientists have gleaned fresh insight into the havoc wreaked by a microscopic culprit that has disrupted marine life this year along the Pacific coast, only tainting Northern California. Delicious supply of tons of crab, but also sickening. Crash gas and sweltering Jupiter-sized world seem to be hiding signs of the water from curious eyes. A recent survey of alien planets known as hot Jupiters revealed that the large number of them without strong signs of water containing clouds and hazes. Over 70% of our planet is covered by ocean, but humanity has explored less than 5% of these waters, even when we prepare to probe oceans and other worlds on our own mains, largely mysterious. Washington, D.C., the El Nino weather pattern will likely prevent much of the U.S. from experiencing a white Christmas this year as warmer air moves throughout the country. And in almost 2 years in limbo, the financially beleaguered daughters of Charity Health System on Monday announced that it's close to a $260 million investment deal with an East Coast hedge fund that will keep one of Bay Area's oldest hospital chains. The Florida boy who made headlines in 2014 after being born with a partial skull due to a rare condition recently met sent in the photos and encountered have started to go viral on Facebook. Hundreds of women are coming forward claiming a popular celebrity endorsed hair care product caused their hair to fall out and severely damage their scalps. Washington, today is the deadline to register for the Affordable Care Act health insurance for coverage started on January 1st, 2016, and those wouldn't register by January 31st could face fines. Peter Challenger's time is now 12:04 on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon here, and it is time now for a stock market report. The Dow up 194.21 points at 17,558.71. S&P 500 up 22.66 points at 2,044.60. And NASDAQ up 46.95 points at 4,999.18. European markets. Dex 10.54.38, up 311.04 points. FDIC 60.17.79, up 143.73 points. CAC 40, up 141.33 points at 4,614.40. Asia markets, Nikkei, down 372.52 points at 18,565.90. Shanghai, down 9.76 points at 3,510.90. HSI, 21.274.37, down 35.48 points. Oil markets, 37.25, up 94 cents. Brent, 36.6, up 74 cents. And natural gas, 1.829, down 65,000 points. Gold markets, 10.61, down $2.40. Silver, 13.715, up 200 points. And copper, 2.0535, down 58,000 points. Bond, US 10 year 2.257%, up 3,200 points. German 10 year 0.6387%, down 1,200 points. And Germany's 10 year yield, 0.30%, up 2,000 points. FX bond, European US dollar, 1.091%, down 8,000 points. US dollar, Japanese yen, 121.67, up 65 cents. And Great British Pound, US dollar, 1.5049, down 91,000 points. Commodities. Wheat, 4.93¼, down 25 cents. Soybean, 8.75¼, down 4. Corn, 3.75¼, down 1.5. Sugar, 14.39, up 8 cents. Coffee, 119.35, down 55 cents. Cotton, 63.12, up, down 26 cents. Rough rice, 10.935, down 5 cents. And cocoa, 3,338, down 37. Live cattle, 120.85, up 2.325. Lean hogs, 58.65, down 1.475. And FD cattle, 150.175, up 2.025 thousand points. Peter Channel News Time is 12:06 and it's time for a sports report. Tonight, the Boston Celtics will be taking on the Cleveland Cavaliers game time at 7:30 p.m. And tonight, the Norton Lancers girls varsity basketball team will have a game against the Ashland Clockers at Norton High School game time 6:30 p.m. Here. The Boston Celtics have surpassed an expectation with a conviction in the first quarter mark in the NBA season. Instead of having an expected mediocre, Boston has risen a higher level, putting any looking to dabble this playoff contention to rest. After Donald Trump stirred controversy by proposing a temporary ban on Muslim men entering the United States, some in the NFL, including Tom Brady, were spoke out against him. As Tom Brady said that Donald Trump is a good friend and he supports his friends. Commissioner Rob Manfred denounces Pete Rose, refusing in-state baseball. And the Pittsburgh Penguins on Monday acquired defenseman Trevor Daly from the Chicago Blackhawks for Skidary. From Skidary. Peter Chellen News on 12:07 on this Tuesday afternoon. It's time for a travel report here on this lunchtime commute here on this Tuesday afternoon. Maybe. Let's start off out in Rhode Island. There where the Jamestown Bridge on the westbound side, the Newport Bridge on the eastbound side. It's a little slow here. Worcester and Providence area commutes are looking good here. In the Worcester area and the Providence area is here. Mass packing in the westbound side. It did slow from Palmer all the way out to Wilbraham. Before approaching the Springfield area here. IE-40 in the eastbound side. It's a little slow before the mass pack in Sturbridge here. Southeast Express and the northbound side. Slow from 3A and Quincy all the way at the Jot Cheshire. Mass packing in the westbound side. Slow from Austin Brett Tolls all the way at the Newton Corner here. Route 3 in the northbound side. A little slow for the Bill Ricker stretch here. In 93 on the northbound side in Derry, New Hampshire, we got an accident here. So expect a few delays here. IA 9 and 993 intersection in Carpenter, it's a little slow. Main turnback on the northbound side, a little slow around New York, Toll Plaza here. And main turnback on the southbound side, an accident after Sacramento, after Route 195, so expect some delays here. And otherwise, it's looking good on the highways and byways in New England on the Tuesday afternoon here. And take a look at MBTA alerts here. Subway system looking good here. Whistleline train 513, 1015 a.m. from outbound is operating 15-20 minutes beyond schedule between Frankman and Worcester to track work. And ferries, they are looking good. Peter Chandler News Time, 12:09 p.m. on this Tuesday afternoon here. And it is time now for a weather report here. Our current conditions here in North Massachusetts at 12:09 p.m. It is 60 degrees with scattered clouds, humidity 47%, wind speed northwest around 17 miles an hour, gusts around 30, and it's wind 2.40 degrees and visibility of 10 miles an hour here. podcast. It is a taste of spring 10 days before Christmas. Here. Current conditions ran in Region 58 in Boston, 57 in Beverly, 52 in Gloucester, 56 in Bedford and Fitchburg, and in Lawrence, 52 in Worcester, 56 in Milford, 54 in Sturbridge, 58 in Norwood, 59 in Taunton and Plymouth and New Bedford, and Falmouth, 56 in Provincetown, 58 in Chatham and Nantucket, 60 degrees in Martha's Vineyard, 55 in Smithfield, 61 in Providence and Westerly, 59 in Montauk, 59 degrees in Block Island, that's 60 in Montauk, 61 in Islip, 60 in New York City, and in Bridgeport and New Haven, 60 in Meriden and 55 in Waterbury, 57 in Danbury, 58 in Hartford and Windlocks, that's 56 in Springfield, 55 in Greenfield, 52 out in Athol, 51 in North Adams, 49 in Pittsfield, 53 in Albany, 52 in Silver Springs, 50 in Mainton, 47 in Brown, Vermont, 40 in Rutland, Vermont, it's 53 degrees in Lemon and Rapture, 52 in Keene, Hampshire, 51 in Jeff, Hampshire, 52 in La Quinta, Hampshire, 56 in Congdon, Hampshire, and in Nashville, Hampshire, 54 in Manchester, Hampshire, 55 degrees out in Portsmouth, Hampshire, 44 degrees up in Portland, Maine, and the water temperature, 49 degrees here. Right, looking at the river outlook around the country shows the station run through the Gulf of Mexico, merging with cold from north central Florida, stretching up and down the Atlantic seaboard, merging warm from western Nova Scotia at the sea, and a pink front stretching through Maine and up in the southern Quebec with low pressure down for southwestern portion of Quebec. Here, for the mile from Ontario, Maine, from Michigan, and northwestern Indiana, and a for the mile from the Dakotas down from north central Nebraska, and a for the mile from north central Nevada, stretching down to seven Idaho, down from northern Utah, down from western Colorado, and a number for the way up and down the California coast here, and a cold front from the Baja California, from the Pacific coast, stretching down for western Mexico and stretching western Texas, and up in western Oklahoma, merging warm front down for Oklahoma, and a pink front from western Kansas, stretching in the east central Colorado, and a warm front from British Columbia here, and a high pressure ridge in central Tennessee, and a high pressure ridge in the inland Pacific Northwest, in southern British Columbia and Alberta here, 45 degrees in Detroit, 46 degrees out in Pittsburgh, 60 degrees out in Washington, D.C., 57 in Atlanta, 80 in Miami, Florida, it's 74 in Brownsville, Texas, it's 58 in Dallas, Texas, it's 40 in Kansas City, 36 in Omaha, 39 in Chicago, 32 in Minneapolis, St. Paul, 10 degrees in Great Falls, Montana, 35 in Seattle, 46 in San Francisco, 44 in Los Angeles, 40 degrees in Las Vegas and Phoenix, Arizona, 27 in Albuquerque, New Mexico, 19 in Denver, and 26 in Salt Lake City, Utah. Here. Okay, let's take a look at the radar situation here, and it's a clear blue day here in Norton here. While we're seeing a few spotty showers here. We're seeing some few spotty showers from Gloucester stretching out of Essex, Ipswich, Hamilton, up into Topsfield, and some spotty rain showers on Andover, and some spotty rain showers around Chelmsford near Lowell in Drake Adair. And we've seen some spotty rain showers along Route 2 from Leominster down for Westminster down for Pitcherville down to Templeton. And spotty rain showers southeast of Pelham, Massachusetts, near the Quabbin Reservoir. And we're seeing a lot of light bands of rain from Peru stretching up to Adams and up into Hancock, Massachusetts, and stretching up to Steventon Center in New York City, and then up down for Berlin and Taconic Lake in New York. Yeah. And we're seeing some spotty rain showers around the Albany, Schenectady, and Gilderland and Altamont areas, and some spotty rain showers around Old Chatham and Rayville and Canaan, New York. And we're seeing some spotty rain showers east of Oneonta and stretching down for Utica, down for northeast of Syracuse, and stretching up in the Adirondacks decks here. And seen some spotty rain showers near the Buffalo area, stretching southeast of Haldimand in Ontario, Canada here. And we're seeing some spotty rain showers southwest of Montreal, Vermont, and some spotty rain showers northeast of Burlington and stretching to southern Quebec. And some spotty rain showers east of Montreal, and some spotty rain and snow sleet showers in northeast of Montreal, southwest of Sainte Claire. And some spotty rain and sleet from northeast of New Hampshire, stretching to western Maine, long route 2 from Rumford down west of Augusta. And some spotty rain showers southwest of portions of Maine, and some spotty rain showers southeast of Kennebec off the main coast here. And we're taking a look at some rain showers from Waterville stretching down east Maine down to southwestern New Brunswick here. And stretching around Nova Scotia, and some sleeting from northeastern portions of Nova Scotia stretching in south central New Brunswick, again some spotty sleet around Bangor, Maine, and some spotty snow showers in central and northern portions of Maine. that for Eastern Quebec, and then up in the New Brunswick and stretching up in the eastern tip of Nova Scotia. So that's why. That is why there is a winter weather advisory for Piscataqua and Penobscot County in Maine, and a winter storm warning for Aroostook County in Maine here. And zooming you out, and it shows a line of rain showers from north central Florida stretching off the Randa Tampa Bay, St. Petersburg area, and some spotty heavy rain showers off the Florida Gulf Coast off the tip of St. Petersburg area. And we're seeing some spotty snow showers from north central portion of Metro and a line of snow showers from eastern and northeastern portion of Colorado stretching in southeastern portion of Wyoming and for western Nebraska and for western Dakotas, and some spotty snow showers in west central portion of Colorado and then for central portion of Wyoming. Spotty snow showers in south central portion of Montana, and some spotty snow showers around the Great Salt Lake area of Utah, and some spotty snow showers in the south north central portions of Nevada here. Patchy rain showers in the western portion of Washington State, and some spotty rain showers in the southeastern portions of Alaska, and some spotty snow showers in the east central portion of British Columbia and west central portion of Alberta, and some spotty snow showers in the southeastern portions of Saskatchewan and the west central and north south central portions of Manitoba here. Okay, let's take a look. Hit the satellite loop here, and it shows a lot of clouds coming to much of Maine, stretching up to eastern Canada here, and some spotty patchy clouds from northwestern Maine and northern New Hampshire and a bit of Vermont, and stretching up eastern New York from Pittsburgh down to Albany, and a lot of clouds from the Rockies of Utah and Colorado, stretching in Wyoming and up to Nebraska, and up into the Dakotas, up to northern Minnesota and northern Great Lakes, up to western Ontario and up to southern Manitoba, and a lot of clouds from Washington State, western up to the Pacific Coast, and a lot of clouds coming to much of British Columbia and Alberta, and patchy clouds from west central Texas and the southern New Mexico and then the west central portion of Mexico here. Okay, let us take a look at and some clouds north central portion of Nevada here. Okay, let us take a look at some weather notes here. As I'm expecting a windy afternoon, so in North England as winds so far goes up to 30 miles per hour so far up in southern New England here. I'm expecting a windy and rainy on Thursday and Friday, followed by a chilly weekend in store here. A mild but windy afternoon is in store for this week. Region beyond the early morning cold front as the high pressure builds into the region. Wednesday is another storm system will bring rain in the region. Thursday into Friday is colder but dry weather expected this weekend. At near term until 6 p.m. this evening. 11:25 a.m. update. Our mass beyond the early morning cold front is not that cold by December standards. Temperatures will be generally rain in the 50s across most locations this afternoon, but a few locations will be around 60 across Norfolk, Oregon, Rhode Island, southeast of Massachusetts may see temperature tick back a degree or two by mid-afternoon as more clouds work in from the west. The scattered broken deck of stratocumulus clouds were beginning to overspread western Massachusetts and Norfolk, Oregon, and should work their way on the coast plains this afternoon. While peaks of sun still expected, the sky being become mostly cloudy at times, especially across interior southern New England, as dry weather should be prevailed but cannot reel out the brief spot sprinkle light shot across the east slopes of the Berkshires, perhaps far northern Massachusetts at upper level energy. The biggest concern remains from northwest wind gusts of 40 to 50 miles an hour this afternoon. Buffkit standards continue to indicate the potential to mix down to 40 to 45 knot winds while from the top of the mixed layer with steep low lapse rates. Therefore, a wind advisory continues for all of southern New England as it is a wind advisory from now until 6 p.m. Wind advisory remains in effect from until 6 p.m. this evening as location wind advisory for most of southern New England here. Winds west 20 to 30 miles an hour with gusts up to 50 miles an hour. Strongest of these winds will likely occur between now and 4 p.m. In fact, strong winds may bring down a few tree limbs and cause very isolated power outages as driver can be also be difficult, especially for high profile vehicles. And drive careful tonight due to poor visibility and slow down and allow extra travel time. And Tuesday, be prepared for a strong wind gust which could make driving difficult or security after a holiday decoration to prevent damage. A wind advisory is issued when sustained winds are forecast to be 31 to 39 miles an hour. Gusts will be ranged between 46 and 57 miles an hour. Winds that strong could be capable of down some small tree limbs and branches, possibly causing isolated power outages. Driving could be difficult, especially for high-profile vehicles. Here, in day one today, tonight, wind advisory day 2 for 7, Wednesday for Monday. No hazard weather expected in this time here. Okay, 7-day forecast goes like this. For today, most nice clouds have about 59 degrees and west about 16 to 18 miles an hour. Gusts as high as 46 miles an hour here. Today, forecast goes about 37 degrees, west about 7 to 11 miles an hour. Gusts as high as 33 miles an hour here. For Wednesday, Putnam's got about 45 degrees, north with about 6 miles an hour here. With that, slight chance of rain after 4 a.m. Most clouds go to about 34 degrees. Calm wind, chance of rain 20%. Thursday, rain like rain after 1 p.m. Clouds got about 53 degrees and southeast wind about 5 to 7 miles by chance of rain 70%. Thursday, rain mean before 4 a.m. Around 46 degrees and chance of rain 8%. Friday, chance of rain before 7 a.m. Then a chance of showers after 7 a.m. Most clouds got about 51 degrees and chance of rain 40%. Friday, chance of showers before 8 p.m. Park clouds got about 31 degrees, chance of rain 30%. Saturday, most of the park clouds got about 40 low about 27 degrees. Sunday, Sunday podcast got about 41 about 28 degrees. And by Monday, podcast got about 47 degrees. Paired by the phrase of the day, a mild and a windy afternoon in store. P with you. Have a good afternoon and goodbye today to us. You at 3 p.m. for a 3 o'clock report. Have a good afternoon here.